In spite of a range of theories and considerable research so far, scientists have not been able to identify one definitive cause for why a person develops OCD. However, there are plenty of theories surrounding the potential causes of OCD, involving one of or a combination of either neurobiological, genetic, environmental factors, learning behaviors, pregnancy, or a specific event which triggered the disorder in a specific individual at a particular point in time. In this video, I'll summarize 5 of the suggested theories, and we'll save the last 5 for my next video. But before I begin, it's important I make it clear that this is just theory, because here's the point. We simply don't know what causes it. Anyhow, what are the theories? 1. Biological factors. Some mental health researchers have encouraged us to think of research on brain scans and similar as indicating that OCD is linked to a biological cause. This research is often described in terms of chemical imbalances in the brain, faulty brain circuitry, or genetic defects. However, despite the recognition that certain parts of the brain are different in OCD sufferers, when compared with non-sufferers, it's still not known how these differences relate to the precise mechanisms of OCD. Brain imaging studies have consistently demonstrated differing blood flow patterns among people with OCD compared with controls, and the cortical and basal ganglia regions are most strongly implicated. However, subsequent meta-analysis studies found that differences between people with OCD and healthy controls were only consistently found in the orbital gyrus and the head of the caudate nucleus.
So yes, whilst it's true to say that sometimes people with OCD are found to have different brain activity, it could be argued this would be expected. A brain scan is sensitive to different patterns of activity in the brain and can, for example, detect the difference in terms of the way the brain reacts between expert musicians listening to music and people with no special knowledge of music.
These areas of the brain become relevant and switched on in particular environments where the person is worrying. It's therefore not surprising that there are brain activation differences between people with OCD and those without. This does not mean that OCD is a biological disease. 2. PANDAS. A 1998 finding implicated the basal ganglia as a key brain region in OCD, with the discovery that in a subgroup of children with OCD, infections may have triggered the disorder. Streptococcal infections trigger an immune response, which in some individuals generates antibodies that cross-react with the basal ganglia. The explanation was that some children begin to exhibit OCD symptoms after a severe strep throat infection. It's thought that the body's natural response to infection, the production of certain antibodies when directed to parts of the brain, might be linked in some way to pediatric autoimmune neuropsychiatric disorders associated with streptococcal infection. In short, PANDAS. This mechanism may explain the subgroup of children in whom OCD develops after a streptococcal infection and worsens with recurrent infections. However, a later 2004 study found no link between subsequent infections and exacerbation of symptoms.
What we do know is that if OCD results from a strep throat infection, the symptoms will start quickly, probably within 1 or 2 weeks. So it could be that pandas, whilst not a cause for OCD, triggers symptoms in children who are already predisposed to the condition, perhaps through genetics or other causal explanations.
3. Genetic factors.
Overall, genetic studies indicate some tendency toward anxiety that runs in families, although this is probably only slight. Some research points to the likelihood that OCD sufferers will have a family member with OCD. In 2001, a meta-analytic review reported that a person with OCD is 4 times more likely to have another family member with OCD than a person who does not have the disorder.
This and other studies have raised the possibility of familial prevalence of OCD and led to a search to identify specific genetic factors that may be involved. However, despite a proliferation of studies and dozens of potential gene candidates suggested, so far, researchers have failed to identify a consistent candidate gene responsible for OCD. We also need to remember that many sufferers do not identify OCD anywhere else in their family or even other anxiety problems. This theory could be further questioned based on speaking to identical twins, where one will have OCD and the other has no anxiety problem at all. What this suggests is that genetics may not be the only cause of OCD, if at all, and that family prevalence of OCD could be learned behaviors in some cases. So, although we cannot rule out genetics, it's clear it's not the whole story, and learned or environment factors may play a more significant part. So there is no obvious benefit to offering biological explanations for the cause of OCD, especially if such suggestions lead those who suffer to dismiss existing psychological treatment methods. 4. Chemical imbalance.
It's common to see and hear mental health professionals describing the cause of OCD in terms of a biochemical imbalance. These approaches have focused on one particular neurotransmitter, serotonin. Serotonin is the chemical in the brain which sends messages between brain cells, and it's thought to be involved in regulating mood, aggression, learning, memory, appetite, sleep, and anxiety. An imbalance in serotonin can cause OCD, they say.
Researchers know that OCD is triggered by communication problems between the brain's deeper structures and the front part of the brain. These parts of the brain primarily use serotonin to communicate. Since OCD is an anxiety disorder, which is marked by low levels of serotonin, this deficiency is a serious and anxiety-producing issue. This is why increasing the levels of serotonin in the brain can help to alleviate OCD symptoms. 5. Psychological theories.
Other research has revealed that there may be a number of other factors which could play a role in the onset of OCD, including behavioral, cognitive, and environmental factors.
For example, according to the learning theory, OCD symptoms are a result of a person developing learned negative thoughts and behavior patterns toward previously neutral situations, which can result from life experiences. Research has revealed a great deal about the psychological factors which maintain OCD, which in turn has led to effective psychological treatment in the form of cognitive behavioral therapy. This information came from these websites. You'll find these links below this video.
If you found this video interesting, please give it a thumbs up and leave a comment in the comment section below. Subscribe to my channel and watch this series from the start. In 2 weeks, I'll be back with a new video in this series on intellectual giftedness, and will give you 5 more theories about what may cause OCD. Till then, I only want to say 3 things. Thank you for watching, take care, and bye for now.